Hello and welcome to Indian Express Opinion. Our top story today is the horrific deaths at the Gorakhpur hospital. About 63 children have died in the last few days. And to discuss this criminal negligence and apathy, I have with me Abantika Ghosh. Abantika, on the eve of Independence Day, when India is celebrating 70 years of independence, we have these absolutely horrifying deaths of 63 children. What happened?
What happened is, like Siddharth Nath Singh, who's the UP health minister, he gave a long list of AES, liver failure, cardiac failure.
AES is acute encephalitis syndrome.
Right. Okay. So all these things, but what I want to highlight, you mm-hmm. mentioned 70 years of independence. This is a few days figures we are talking about. Mm-hmm. In 2014, 567 children died in this hospital at the rate of 19 per day. 2015, 668 children died at the rate of 22 per day. 2016, 587 died at the rate of 20 per day. We are outraging about one day when there were 23 deaths.
These are chilling figures, Abantika.
Yes.
Can you repeat them, please? In 2014?
2014, 19 per day. 2015, 22 per day. 2016, 20 per day. It was marginally better in till August 2017 when it was 11 per day, and that shot to 23 deaths on August 10th when mm-hmm. whatever went wrong, went wrong.
So you're saying that this has been going on for some time and
so
nobody has cared.
I also have the National Family Health Survey 4, which happened in 2015-16 for the mm-hmm. first time, brought out district-specific figures.
Okay.
I want to read out some of these figures from Gorakhpur.
Okay.
It's not about one hospital, and let's also face it. A tertiary care hospital, I mean, they might have been negligent. There's a report going on. I have nothing for the hospital. All I want to highlight is that we tend to cover health issues in a sort of knee-jerk way, mm-hmm. which is
when medical emergencies take place.
Yeah, and when many more kids were already dying, and for years they have been dying, we were silent. Everybody was silent. So, in 2015-16, when NFHS4 happened, mothers who had received full antenatal care, that was only 9.1% in Gorakhpur. Children in the age of 12 to 23 months who had been fully immunized, which means BCG, measles and 3 doses each of polio and DPT, that's 65.4% children. Children under 6 months exclusively breastfed is 56.6.
Mm-hmm.
This is just above half.
So, and these are figures for Gorakhpur only?
Only Gorakhpur.
So across the political spectrum, whether at the time in 2014 the Akhilesh Yadav government, the Samajwadi government was in power.
Yes.
So things have not changed between 2014 at least, or perhaps even earlier, to 2017 when the BJP government comes to power.
Infant mortality rate
in
Gorakhpur
yeah.
is 62 per thousand live births.
Mm-hmm.
In Uttar Pradesh it's 48 per thousand live births.
How would you compare that, say, with the best states? Presumably Kerala and Tamil Nadu.
India, the India figure is 40.
I see.
Kerala is, I think, somewhere around 12, 14, if I'm not mistaken, per thousand live births. And so that is where Gorakhpur stands. It's not just one place or one hospital. It's also that a hospital that is getting very sick babies from across that area. You know, we've reported today about these sick newborn care units which are supposed to come up. My sources are telling me that the one in Balia, people leave at 2 o'clock. If you have a sick newborn care unit running 24/7 and you have a really sick baby there, then you have to be there, or somebody has to be there 24 hours a day. Who wants to be there? So they leave at 2 o'clock while the kids are packed off to this hospital.
Who leaves at 2 o'clock? The staff leaves at 2 o'clock?
That's what I'm told. That's
so there's nobody there in the neonatal unit?
Yes, these SNCUs that were supposed to cater 24/7 to sick kids.
Mm-hmm.
I'm told, I have not been there, but very responsible people are telling me that these kids are sent here because they don't stay there all the time, the staff.
I see. So there's nobody in charge. It's basically the parents and their children, their sick children.
Right. Right, and it's the state government's health is a state subject. It's the state government's responsibility to implement projects or to oversee the functioning. That's all their responsibility.
It sounds absolutely horrifying, Abantika. So, what is the government saying today? if this is such a systemic problem, but is this only in government hospitals, or do we find this across the private healthcare as well as government healthcare?
No, there is, in a private health setup, staff cannot just leave. There is slightly more accountability. There are other issues there, pricing, needless tests. Those are different issues.
Right.
Problems are different. But there is accountability. The staff has to be there. They will see you. What they do to you is a different question. And let me also tell you that, I mean, and I firmly believe this, that government health setup is hugely maligned. But health, whatever health we have in this country, the backbone is the government health setup. If government doctors weren't working so hard,
so is one of the reasons that the doctors are overworked?
Yes, of course. This hospital is 200 beds. It has some...
Which one? The Gorakhpur Hospital?
Gorakhpur Hospital. It has some 2,500, 3,000 patients coming in every day. There are babies sharing neonatal warmers. The hospital, no hospital can handle this kind of pressure.
So along with Japanese encephalitis, which is endemic to the region, we still don't know why that this problem has not been solved so far. Because the story has been going on for years.
Answer to the why here. So households using improved sanitation facility, which would mean a proper toilet, that's the 34.3. Mm-hmm. That's the percentage of households using improved.
So 66% of the population is still going out to the fields for urination.
That's
and
what this survey says, and this is a government survey.
So you're saying then that along with the problem of the disease, which in this case is Japanese encephalitis, are you also talking about you're talking about overworked doctors and medical staff?
Infrastructure which is grossly insufficient.
Tell me something, can you make the link between political sort of care, in the sense that unless the politician in whichever government, whether it's the BJP government or its previous incarnation in the Samajwadi, that the lack of attention to this very critical aspect of human life, which is health care, that allows doctors or medical staff to go scot-free?
Absolutely.
Can you make that connection?
Absolutely. See, I would actually go one step ahead and say that even as voters, we don't demand good health care. We demand good roads. We demand... We don't demand good hospital, a good PHC. That's never...
So at the risk of sounding callous, Abantika, you're saying that children have been dying for years in Gorakhpur and in the region.
Yes.
Well, how is it that this story became such a crisis and such a national headline these last few days?
I can only assume that somebody put the figures together and sort of played it up, and that's when we all started reacting. That's because... These figures are from UP government. These are figures from UP government.
So what is the government doing now? The Chief Minister as well as the Health Minister have visited the
formed
hospital.
A committee to examine what went wrong. The principal has been removed. We're told that this oxygen supplier was threatening to cut oxygen supply for many days.
Do you think that was a critical problem, that the lack of oxygen at that critical time?
Those were the initial reports, but the government now is saying, at least the actually one question that the health minister did not answer is that all these kids died of different problems, but how many of these kids were on oxygen?
Mm-hmm.
That question remains unanswered.
So that linkage hasn't been made
every
yet.
Time you ask them that, they are saying, we've formed this committee, we'll wait for the report and all that. So, but there was negligence certainly, because in a hospital like this, which has all these sick babies coming in, if your supplier is saying that I will cut supply, you better give me your money, and then the money is released to you on the 5th of August, yet you don't release it to the supplier till 11th. So there's something was happening.
Okay.
So today the health minister is actually on record saying somewhere that he, I'm told he was trying to cut some deals. So
I see.
Everything was going wrong.
Okay, so corruption even in the hospital.
Yes, that's what he seems to suggest.
Okay, so which is, if you ask people in Uttar Pradesh or perhaps even in the in the health ministry,
yes,
will tell you off the record that that's not so unusual.
It isn't.
Okay. Bandhika, thank you for your time, for explaining this very chilling story to us, to putting it into perspective, to say that this problem has been taking place for the last several years across governments and that the political class has turned a blind eye. But some things have to change. Please continue to read the Indian Express and watch this space for stories to come. Thank you so much for watching.